Well, thank you very, very much, and
good afternoon, everyone. It's wonderful to be with you. It's especially wonderful to be here in NASA. I take a point of, as we would, you would say in the Senate, personal privilege to say how good it is to be with the administrator. I can't help but thinking of him as senator for the many years that I had the honor of working, in effect, for him as staff director of the Foreign Relations Committee. So, Mr. Administrator, it's wonderful to be here with you and with the women and men of NASA at headquarters, together with friends from JAXA. And I realize that I'm actually sharing this podium with three people who've been to space, the administration included. Mr. Prime Minister, it's an honor to sit with you, with my friend, Foreign Minister Hayashi, and with our ambassadors as well. This week, our governments have been holding incredibly productive and wide-ranging meetings that underscore that on virtually every issue of consequence to our people in Japan and the United States alike, we are stronger together. Our bilateral partnership is among the strongest in the world, in part because we're always adapting it to meet the evolving challenges of our time. And that's the case on everything from advancing security and stability in the Indo-Pacific, to bolstering our economic and energy security, to defending the rights at the core of the United Nations Charter. We're also expanding the horizons of our partnership in a very literal way, through space cooperation. And here, I also want to thank Vice President Harris for her leadership as chair of the National Space Council. For decades now, Japan and the United States have worked together to extend humanity's reach in space. We've long collaborated to support the International Space Station. We were two of the first signatories of the Artemis Accord that the Prime Minister referred to. We're partners in the Artemis program, which will return astronauts to the lunar surface, including the first woman and the first person of color. We've just signed a new arrangement to support the Lunar Gateway, which will prepare for future missions to Mars. The framework agreement that we're about to sign will take our cooperation to new heights. It'll strengthen our partnership in areas like research on space technology and transportation, robotic lunar surface missions, climate-related missions, and our shared ambition to see a Japanese astronaut on the lunar surface. In the last century, the space race electrified the world, seizing the imaginations of millions of people, awed by the men and women who dared to go into the unknown. It inspired generations of scientists, researchers, innovators, dreamers, and it paved the way for countless technological advances in computers, satellites, GPS, camera lenses, medical equipment, and so much more. And these advances have improved the daily lives of people across the planet. Now, we're entering a new chapter of space exploration, and our ambitions are no less soaring than in President Kennedy's time when he declared his commitment to landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to Earth within the decade. And our achievements, I believe, will be no less impressive or important for the benefit of humankind. But even more than in the past, we will reach new frontiers through an approach that is fundamentally collaborative. We've seen what international space collaboration can achieve. Just in the last 2 years, it put a rover on Mars and launched the most powerful space telescope ever, the James Webb Space Telescope. Just this week, that telescope confirmed the existence of an exoplanet for the first time, an Earth-sized planet located 41 light-years away from us. With Japan, our countries will soon make similar incredible discoveries as we prepare to send a probe to Mars' moons, explore the South Pole of our moon, and more. Agreements like the one that we're signing today help create and strengthen the partnerships that are at the heart of this extraordinary progress. We need to harness the world's collective vision and all of our strengths to reach these new horizons. Major General Bill Anders, a member of Apollo 8, the first human spaceflight to reach the moon, said, and I quote, "We came all this way to explore the moon, and the most important thing is that we discovered the Earth." He understood that one of space exploration's greatest powers, maybe one of its greatest gifts, is to bind people together across continents, across oceans, in pursuit of knowledge, in pursuit of understanding. It's in that spirit that the United States and Japan take this step. Thank you very much.